Friends, the thought of Swami Vivekananda are eternal, and we must always remember true immortality is to be achieved by creating something of value to the world, something that will outlive ourselves. Our Puranic stories teach us something valuable. They teach us that those who chase immortality almost never got it. But those who had the goal of serving others almost always became immortal. As Swamiji himself said, only those live who live for others. This can also be seen in Swami Vivekananda's life. He did not go out to achieve anything for himself. His heart always beat for the poor of our country. His heart always beat for the motherland which was in chains. Friends, Swami Vivekananda did not see spiritual and economic progress as mutually exclusive. Most importantly, he was against the approach where people romanticize poverty. In his lectures about practical Vedanta, he says, and I quote, "The fictitious difference between religion and the life of the world must vanish, for the Vedanta teaches oneness," unquote. Swamiji was a spiritual giant, a highly elevated soul. Yet, he did not renounce the idea of economic progress for the poor. Swamiji was a sannyasi himself. He never sought for himself a single paisa of money, but he helped raise funds to build great institutions. These institutions have fought poverty and promoted innovation.